In today's modern age of technology, there are many sophisticated recording devices to help capture images and record sound. However, when using these devices, it's important to know how to successfully tell your story to an audience. Meet Dan and Anastasia. They're intelligent young individuals who are going to show you how to do just that. But before they get started, they first have something to share with you. Don't you, Dan and Anastasia? At the beginning of your team's video, you must provide the following introduction. This is team, include your team's name, and we chose the, include the name of your challenge. The title of our video is, and include your video's title. And most importantly, for safety's sake, do not give any identifying information such as location or team member names. Entries that do not follow this script exactly will be disqualified. Next, Anastasia is going to show you the proper way to hold a camera. Notice Anastasia is holding her camera firmly with both hands, but not too tight, keeping her elbows close to her body. This helps maintain a steady image and reduces shaking. If available, you may also use a tripod, books, or boxes to steady your camera. Do you notice something else? Look closely. Anastasia is holding her camera horizontally and not vertically. Record all your video with your camera in this position. This will help your video look much better. Always keep bright lights behind you, not your subject. Watch how Dan tries to shoot a video with a light behind Anastasia. Because video cameras adjust automatically for light, Dan's lens will close down because it's too bright. Anything that isn't bright will be very hard to see. However, if Dan keeps his brightest light behind him and not facing his camera, his image will look swell. Don't shoot at low angles. This will not be flattering. Notice how Anastasia is holding her camera just slightly above Dan's eye level. Shooting slightly above the subject's eye level will provide you with a much more pleasing image. For the best quality audio, connect an external microphone to your camera. However, if you do not have a microphone, move in close to your audio source. Otherwise, you may not record the audio loud enough for your audience to hear it. Now that you've shot your video, you're ready for the edit. A variety of video editing programs are available on your computer or online. These programs can show you how to put together still images and video clips. For more neat ideas on telling your story with video, visit NASA's DIY podcast at www.nasa.gov/audience/foreducators/DIY podcast. Well, thanks, Dan and Anastasia. You've shown us some really handy-dandy tips for making our videos just splendid. Now it's up to you. Get out there and make your video really super.